self-drive on Xpeng. Today we are going to talk about this functionality in our cars. So we are going to talk about what features and functionalities we have, how to enable them, disable them, how to activate them during a trip. We will see how the car handles these situations, if there are room for improvement. We are going to talk also about mistakes and errors that users do while using these functionalities. So welcome back to the channel. My name is Hugo. I am in Portugal and this is the Xpeng G6 Diaries. Let's go for it. We are in the car. So let's start by going to the settings of the car to see what we can do in self-drive. So we just need to go to driver assistance. And here we have first the active safety. So guys, if you saw my previous video on safety, you can check it on top of this video. You will see the detailed information on all these options here and what they can do in the car. And then we have then the self-driving. We only have two options here. So the car do implement a free level driving assist. So for the self-driving, and the first one is ACC. It is basically adaptive cruise control. So it's not an option that you can disable here in the car, but it's always present here in the car. So ACC, it's not more than a cruise control system. So I think all of you know what the cruise control system is. But in this case, it's adaptive. And why is it adaptive? Because it will adjust itself based on the conditions of the traffic. So basically the traffic in front of you. Then you have lane centering control, that is LCC. And in this case, you can disable it in the car. So if you don't want to use it, you can just disable it here in the configuration. And lane centering control will work on top of ACC. So you cannot have lane centering control without ACC. It will keep you inside your lane. So it will analyze the lane limits and will keep you centered to that lane. Then you have another option here, that it's auto lane change. So you can activate these and the car will assist you to make automatic lane changes. Okay guys, so let's start from the beginning, how to activate and how to deactivate ACC and LCC. So to activate, you need to use this lever here, this talk, or if you have configured the wheel drive, there is one button that can be configured, that is this one. You can configure that on the settings of the car to activate also the ACC and LCC. But let's consider that you are going to use the basic functionality, that it's the stalk. So to activate ACC, that is the first level, that is just adaptive cruise control, you just need to press once down and the car will activate ACC. And then you just need to use this wheel here to change the speed that you want to have the car running. Okay, so now I have set it to 120, as you can see here, and the car will keep these speeds during the route until you deactivate this. Well, another thing, as this is the adaptive cruise control, you can also specify the distance to the car in front of you. That is why this is adaptive cruise control. So even if it is defined to 120, if you have a car in front of you that it's only riding at 100, then the car will reduce the speed. I don't know if you saw it on the dashboard. Let me show you very quickly. So if we just click here, you will see here the adjustment increasing and decreasing on the dashboard. For the LCC, that it's level 2, we need to have this LCC icon here at gray. Okay, see that it blinks sometimes. I will activate now, 2 times down, and the system activates both systems. As you can see, now I have ACC at 127, I will reduce to 120, that is the speed limit of this highway, and LCC it's blue, so, and you see also here the corridor in blue, stating that the car is on LCC self-drive, so the level 2 that it's available here in Europe for the Xpeng. The car is going to control speed and also keep the car centered in the lane that you are. With this, to deactivate the system, you just need to press up the stalk, or you can just press the brake
and I will do it now, and the system will deactivate immediately. And as you can see, now I am driving manually because the system deactivated the self-drive mode in the car. So, some things that are important to state while we are in self-drive mode. First, let me show you here on the dashboard, because on the settle screen it doesn't show. You see here there is an icon that is for the overtaking. So the icon needs to be activated so that the car can do a lane change, automatic lane change, okay? And so I will do a couple of them so that you understand what they will do. But first, as we are approaching a truck, you will see that the ACC will then reduce the speed based on the speed that the truck itself is going. So as you can see now, we have already we are already at 100 kilometers more or less, even though that LCC and ACC it's to 120. So now I will perform a lane change, and for that I will just signal the car and it will do it automatically, and it will increase the speed based on the setting that was defined, and we will do a lane change and an overtake of the truck here. I will then wait for this other truck, and I will then do another lane change to go back to my lane, and for that I will just signal the car to do a lane change, and the car, as soon as it is possible to do, it will do it automatically for us, and then keep again the car centered in the lane. So this is the basic functionality of the self-drive. Now just a couple of informations on what you can expect that happens while you are in this mode. So first of all, you probably already saw some messages saying that I need to keep my hands on the wheel. So I will keep them out so that you understand what I am saying. And the car from time to time will tell me that I need to do some pressure in the wheel drive just to make sure. So it is now here, as you can see, and I just need to press a little bit on the wheel drive so that it knows that I am here. You know that in Europe, so self-drive is assisted, so it is mandatory that we are still in control of the car. Some topics that are important: if you are in this mode and if you want to overtake a car in front of you, you don't need to turn off the LCC, you just need to press accelerator. So if I press accelerator, you will see a message in the dashboard saying that it cannot slow down the car if I have my pedal in the accelerator, okay? Because if I leave the accelerator, then the car will then slow down to the speed that it was defined, okay? So if you want to, let's go and overtake this car that it's slower than 120, I will accelerate, and I am overtaking now the control of the system to overtake the car, and as soon as I leave the car again, it will turn again on and reset to the speed that I was in. So this is, instead of deactivating the LCC and ACC, you can just overtake for a small moment, just pressing the accelerator, and it will obey to your command and accelerate the car based on that acceleration. Also, for the lane change, I will overtake also the lane change, automatic lane change. So how to do it? It's very simple. So I'm just overtaking the truck, I will signal my left and I will go, and then as soon as I just leave the car again, it will turn on again the LCC without you doing anything. So I'm just showing you this because sometimes when we are in self-drive mode, we think that we cannot do anything to the car unless we turn off the system, but no, we can do everything in the car. So the other thing that I would like to mention is some mistakes that we sometimes do doing self-drive. One of the things that I took many time to get used to is, for instance, the line change. You cannot turn the wheel if you activate the line change by automatic line change, because if you do so, then the car will understand that you want to
do it by yourself.
So I will then activate the turn signal. It will see it activates, but then I will force and it stopped, and then immediately it will jump again to the lane and it will stay here. To do lane change, you just need to press the stalk for the lane change, and then the car will do everything for you. Okay, you cannot press and force the change of the lane for you.
So guys, as you saw, the base system of the self-drive in the Xpeng, it's very simple. So you have, in fact, three levels, let's call it like that. So as I mentioned before, we have the ACC, that it's adaptive cruise control, and it will be the system that is responsible to control the speed of the car and taking in consideration, of course, the traffic in front of you so that it can adapt the speed where you are and that you have defined. Then you have the lane centering control, that it's going to be the system that it's going to be responsible to keep you inside your lane. And of course, in the highway, if you have these two on, so you are going to drive in the defined speed and the car will make the turns for you inside the highway. And then the third one, it's the assisted lane change. So basically what this does is when you press the stalk to change the lane, the car will identify on the lane that you want to go, if it is possible to do it or not. If it is not, it will give you a message in a red box and it will not do. But if it is possible, it will show a blue rectangle and the car will move by itself. So you don't need to do anything on that. And the car will move to that lane. The system itself can do one thing very easily, that it's if you overtake the system for any reason, so if you want to accelerate to overtake a car, or if you are in a situation that you need to move a little bit faster or something like that, or if you want to change the lane, you can just press the stalk, do the lane change, go back, and as soon as you are inside the lane again, the systems will automatically engage again, so you don't need to re-engage the system by yourself. So the only thing that you cannot do, use the brakes or press the stalk up, because this is just a clear indication to the system that you want to stop to use self-drive. Finally, let me give you just a couple of notes and the improvements that still need to be made. So I have been using ACC and LCC since the first day that I have the car. And in the previous version, the 5.4.5, I stopped using it almost completely because the ride was very, very, very bumpy. What I mean, a car does slow down and even brakes a bit as soon as you reach any turn in the highway. So even if you were with a 100 km per hour speed defined in a highway that was has a speed limit of 120, as soon as you reach a turn, it will slow down a little bit and then accelerate again and then slow down again. So in the same turn, it will do this a couple of times. So it's a very bumpy process, so it's not comfortable to do, okay? Also, the lane change was very slow for me. So every time you press the lane change, the car will analyze the surroundings, define where it goes, and then starts moving very slowly to that place. And it's a very slow process, at least for me. On this new version, the 5.6, these systems were a little bit improved, okay? So I already saw that, for instance, when I am at 100 kilometers per hour, the system does not do many slowdowns, okay? But at 120, it still does. So the system can be improved on this. Also, on the lane change assist, even though I believe that it's faster now, for me at least, but this is something that I would not consider an improvement or something that needs to be addressed by Xpeng, but this is somehow a habit that I need to change, and probably most of you using these systems do feel the same thing as I do. Because usually when I press the stalk, I already saw the side mirrors and I already know that I can do the overtake. So I can do already the lane change. What happens is that when I do all this, so I have already the security measures in place. When I press the stalk, the car will redo everything because of course the car didn't know. that I already know that it's safe. So it will start analyzing the surroundings with the cameras, identifying the cars, identifying the place to change the lane, and then start moving. What happens when you are in a highway is that sometimes I just looked, I see a car that it's coming even in the lane where I'm going to move, but it's still far away. But as soon as I press the stalk, as the car goes a little, some steps behind before to start analyzing, when it starts moving, there is the car coming, and then he will abruptly stop and return back to the lane, and with the message that he cannot do. It could if it was faster. So this is just a habit that needs to be changed. So I cannot expect that the car knows already and it's analyzing already all possible lane changes, even though that I am not indicating that I want to do a lane change. So it's not something to be improved. It can be a little bit because it could be faster to identify everything. But it's also a habit from the users itself, from the drivers, that we need to take in consideration that the car should do a couple of verifications for safety before doing some of these maneuvers. So basically, this is it, guys. I think it's I have managed to cover all about self-driving. So activating, deactivating, also enabling and disabling some of the options inside the car, and also how to execute the maneuvers, how the car handles on the ACC, on the LCC, and also on the auto lane change. So guys, thank you very much again for watching this video, to be here with me. I would love you to leave a like, to subscribe to the channel, and also if you have any question or any doubt or any comment at all, just leave in the comments below, and I will see you in the next one. Thank you. Bye-bye.